Okay, I've just rounded the final quarter on my quilt. Now, on a larger quilt, you would keep sewing down the corner until you get about 8 to 10 inches away from where the end of your binding strip stops. On a mini quilt or a small table topper like this one, I'm not going to have to sew very far down that fourth side. So I'm going to sew just a little bit, back stitch, take it off, and I'm going to check and see where I am. Okay, now we've got the beginning of the binding strip that we left free when I started sewing, and I've got the end of my binding strip, which extends well past. What you want to do is you're going to overlap the end of the binding strip on top of the free binding strip that you have left over from when you started. And the way you know how much of this to cut off depends on the width of your binding strip. So I'm using a 2-inch binding strip, and so I'm going to extend the end of the binding past the beginning exactly 2 inches. And I'll use a ruler to measure that. So, and also you want to make sure and pull these taut so there aren't any gaps. So pull them taut, both strips, and 2 inches past the end of the first strip is where you're going to cut the top strip. And I usually just keep some scissors handy and make a little snip with my ruler and then cut that strip the rest of the way off. Okay, so now you have the end of your binding strip, the beginning of your binding strip. Now we're going to join these together using a diagonal seam just in the same way that you joined the strips of binding together. Sometimes I just bunch up my quilt a little bit. Now this is important. The end of the binding strip goes on the bottom with the beginning of the binding strip on top. And we're going to line them up the same way that we did before. And again, we're going to draw a diagonal line from the top left corner of the top strip down to the bottom right corner of the bottom strip. We're going to draw that line, then we're going to sew on that line and trim like we did before. Okay, I've drawn the line. I'm going to sew on the line. And now we have exactly kind of what we had before when we were sewing our binding strips together. We have a diagonal seam. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to trim this a quarter of an inch away from the sewn line. And I'm also going to press this open. You might be tempted to try to eyeball this, but it really does help to draw these lines for your diagonal seams. It just makes your binding straighter. Okay, I'll go trim this and press it and be right back to show you the finishing. Okay, I've trimmed and pressed and I've laid out the binding and it fits pretty good on my quilt. Now, occasionally, if your binding strip is just a tiny bit bigger than your quilt top, you can actually flip your quilt top over and sew from the bottom of your quilt, and your presser feet will actually ease that binding strip in so you don't have any puckers. So that's a trick to try if you are having a little issue. Sometimes that happens if you haven't pulled the pieces of fabric taut enough. So now we're just going to finish sewing from where we left off and all the way until where we began, and we will have our binding attached all the way around the edges of our quilt. Okay. The binding is completely sewn around all four sides of our quilt. This next step is something that my grandmother taught me that really seems to help. I take my finished quilt top and binding next over to the ironing board And from the top of the quilt, I'm going to press the binding flat around all four edges. So I'll do that next, and then I'll meet you over at the cutting table for the final steps. Okay, we're back. I've pressed the binding out over at the ironing board. At the corners, I don't worry about it. I just press up into this part, and I press right here, and I've left the corners alone. So now it's time to turn the binding to the back side of the quilt and get ready for hand stitching. Now I have this little bag of Clover Wonder Clips. I love these. I started out using pins and then I used hair clips, but these are the best way to secure your fabrics for binding. They don't fall off, which is great if you have babies or pets. They don't poke you like pins do, and they're just really easy to use. Now you'll start by pulling your binding over to the back side of your quilt, and you'll want to be sure to cover up the stitching line from when you sewed it to the front side of the quilt. So you're going to pull it back, and you're going to use the Clover Wonder Clips to secure the binding to your quilt. Now, I like to clip my entire quilt before I sit down to do the hand stitching, and that way it's ready to go. I can take it with me to a ball game or on a vacation. Some people just like to clip a short way, stitch it, and then use their clips to clip the next little section. But I do generally clip the whole quilt before I start hand stitching. Today though, I won't. I'll just clip part of it so I can show you the hand stitching in a second. I do want to show you the corners though. The corners are essential to get right. You know, you have kind of that funny edge from the way that we attach the binding. I kind of leave the corner alone for a minute, and I clip the edges before the corner and after the corner. Okay, so I've got the sides clipped, and now I'm going to do the corner. I fold the side over my stitching, and I keep that fold. I just keep my finger there to hold it, and I'll usually add another clip in right there. And then I fold the top down. I'm going to create that mitered corner with my fold, and the top piece of binding will meet the binding on the right hand side right at that corner. So we're going to have that perfect corner. On the back side, we will also have a perfect mitered corner. So both sides will have that mitered finish, and as soon as I get that clipped or held in place, I'll put a clip on that corner and finish clipping the other side. And once you have the whole quilt ready to go, you can start doing your hand stitching. Okay, so you have the binding all ready to go. You have a couple of different options for doing your stitching. I really like to hand stitch mine using just a slip stitch on the back of the quilt. The stitching won't show through to the front, and it's just a really relaxing thing to do. Some people prefer to stitch by machine, and if you're going to do that, you actually will do that from the front of the quilt, and you will stitch in the ditch right in between your binding and your quilt, and what that will do is that will catch the binding on the back side. So that's another option for finishing your quilt. I hope this binding quilt tutorial has helped you. It's always fun to turn the quilt around and look at the front side, and you can kind of get an idea what it's going to look like once the binding is sewn. Thanks so much for stopping by, and if you haven't already, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.